Hello students, we are doing chapter number 5 sets and today we will start exercise 5.2. But before that we will discuss what we have done in last exercise. So last exercise we discussed about the set. Set is a well-defined collection and always it is denoted by capital letters of English alphabet. And we have three ways to represent our set. First method is description method. In this method we have to write the property of set or the definition of set. Suppose if I will take a set A and what I am taking starting first 5 natural number. So this is the property of my set. I am taking first 5 natural number. And description method you can represent into the flower bracket or without flower bracket also, it is not compulsory. Second method is roster or tabular form. In tabular form we will write the elements inside the flower bracket separated by the comma. So first 5 natural numbers. So first 5 natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this method is tabular form or roster form. Third method we have set builder form or rule method. In this method we will mix these two. So first we will write x such that x means how is the x. Now we have to write the property of x. So x such that x is first 5 natural numbers. So x is the text and then you have to mention the definition of your set. So these are the three methods to represent the set. Now in second exercise you will learn about types of sets. So first type is finite set. Finite set means if a set is having countable number of elements then we will call it a finite set. For example, I have taken here one set A, 1, 2, 3, 4. So easily I can count how many elements are there inside this 4 element. So if you are able to count the number of elements then we will call it a finite set. Second one, infinite. By name only you can guess, infinite means which we cannot count. So here set of natural number I have taken as example. So set of natural number will start from 1, 2, 3 and it will go up to infinity. And up to infinity means we cannot count how many numbers are there in this set. So this set we will call infinite set. Third type of set is singleton set. By name only it is clear, single means if a set is having only one element then we will call it a singleton set. For example, natural satellite of Earth. So Earth, how many natural satellites are there for Earth? Only one. So natural satellite of Earth is Moon. So only one. When you are getting one element as answer, that is singleton set. Fourth type is empty set. Empty set or null set means having no element, zero element. And we will denote it by empty bracket or this symbol. This is psi symbol. So for example, if I say natural number between 3 and 4. So between 3 and 4 we don't have any natural number. So our answer will be here empty set. After empty set, few more types of set you will learn in this chapter, in this exercise. Next is universal set. Universal set is a set which contains all the elements in a given problem. Maybe in given problem you have one set or two set or three set, and universal set will be the combination of all these set together. All the sets will include in this, and we will denote universal set by this symbol or by this symbol. Any one symbol you can represent universal set. For example, if I will say I have a set A of vowels, then the universal set of vowel will be English alphabet set. And for consonant also set of English alphabet will be the universal set for vowels and universal set for consonants. Next thing is cardinal number of a set. Cardinal number of a set means the number of elements in a set. So you have to count the number of elements and that is the cardinal number. For example, A is having A, B, C, D. Four elements are there. So, how we will write? We will write N in bracket A. N in bracket A means cardinal number of A. How many elements? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, cardinal number of A is 4. Next, equal sets. For equal sets, here sets word is there. It means two sets we are comparing. So, equal by equal only you can guess. If two sets are exactly same means same elements should be there in both the sets. For example, A is having 1, 2, 3 and B is having 3, 2, 2, 1. So, here repetition we will ignore. A is having 1, then check in B, A is 1 is there, 2, 2 is also there, 3 and 3 is also there. So, A is having 1, 2, 3 element, B is also having 1, 2, 3 element. So, A and B are equal sets. Next, equivalent set. In equivalent set, we will compare only the number of elements. It is not compulsory both the sets have exactly same elements. Only the number of elements we will compare. So, I have taken here example, A is having 1, 2, 3 elements and B is having A, B, C, 3 elements. So, 3 elements are here, 3 elements are here. It means A and B are equivalent set. And for equivalent, we will use this symbol, double-sided arrow symbol. Next thing is subset. A is called the subset of B if every elements of A is in B. If you have two sets A and B, here I have taken two sets, A is 1, 2, 3 and B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now see, if every element of A is in B, A is having 1, yes it is in B, 2, yes it is also in B, 3, it is also in B. It means A is the subset of B and we will call B is the superset of A. A is subset of B and B is the superset of B. So, how we will write? A is subset of B. And for B also we can check whether B is the subset of A or not. 1 is there, yes. 2 is there, yes. 3 is there, yes. But 4 is not there in A. So, B is not the subset of A. A is the subset of B, but B is not the subset of A. And for not subset, we will put this symbol. For subset, we will put this symbol. For subset, always remember, empty set is the subset of every set. Because empty set is empty, nothing is there. So, we can consider it as a subset of every set. Next, every set is the subset of itself. A is the subset of A. Because A, if A is having 1, 2, 3, this A also having 1, 2, 3, so A is the subset of A. Every set is subset of universal set and every set is the subset of universal set because universal set contain all the elements included in problem. And if A is the subset of B and B is subset of A, then we can say A and B are equal because all the elements of A are in B. And B, all the elements are in A. And this condition will be possible only when A and B are equal. Now we will start exercise 5.2. Question number 1. Classify the following sets into empty set, finite set, infinite set. In case of finite set, mention the cardinal number. So first is given all colors of a rainbow. So we know how many colors are there in rainbow? 7 colors are there. And that names are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. So, total 7 colors are there. You can learn like this also. Vibjor. Word is there. Vibjor. Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. And how many elements are here? This is a finite set because 7 elements are there. So, this is a finite set. And cardinal number is 7 because 7 elements are there. Second part is x such that x is a prime number between 7 and 11. So, now we will count after 7, 8. 8 is not a prime number. 9 is also not a prime number and 10 is also not a prime number. It means this is a empty set. So for empty set cardinal number, no need to write, it is 0. Only for finite set we have to write the cardinal number. So this is a empty set. Next, third part, multiples of 5. So multiple of 5 means 5 table you have to continue. 5 1 ja 5, 10, 15, 20, and it will go up to infinity, because here limit is not mentioned. Multiple of 5 only written. It is not written first 5 multiple or first 10 multiple. Then it means we have to write up to infinity. So up to infinity means this set is infinite set, and for infinite set also we should not write here cardinal number. Next, we have all straight lines drawn in a plane. So if you have a plane, how many straight line you can draw? We can draw infinite number of straight lines. So here infinite lines will come. So infinite means which we cannot count. So this set will be infinite set. Next, fifth part we have, x such that x is a digit in the numeral 5501315 27. So which digits we are using here? We are using 5 0 1 3 2 and 7. We will not repeat. 5 is coming 3 times, so we will write here 1 time. 1 is coming 2 times, so we will write only 1 time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total here 6 elements are there. So this is a finite set. And cardinal number is 6. Next to sixth part, x such that x is a letter in word sufficient. So letters we have to mention here. We are using here S, U, I, C, E, N, and T. F is coming 2 times, I is also coming 2 times, but we have to write only 1 time. So this is also a finite set. And cardinal number is here. Count the number of elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 elements are there. Next we have, x such that x is equal to 4n. And n is your integer and less than 10. So if this n we will see, this n we will get integer means we have to take negative numbers also, positive numbers also. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. 2 and till 9 we have to take, because less than 10. So you can see this side it is coming up to infinity. This side okay, this side limit is there, till 9 only it will go. But left side it will go up to infinity. So if we write the multiple of 4, then this side it will be up to infinity. Then here we will get minus 12, minus 8, minus 4, then 0, 4, 8, 12. Like this up to 36 we will get. So you can see here this in this direction it is going up to infinity. So this is also a infinite set. We cannot count here elements. Next one, x says that x belongs to natural number and x is a prime factor of 180. So we have to do the prime factor of 180. Do the factor of 180, use only the prime number, 290 times, 245 times, then 315 times, 3 5 times and 5 1 time. These are the prime factor. So prime factors are here 2, 3 and 5. We will not repeat. 2 is coming 2 times, but we will write 1 time. 3 is also 2 times, we will write 1 time. So you can see here this is a finite set. We can count number of elements here and cardinal number is 3. X says that x is a vowel in the word y. So Y vowels are A, E, I, O, U, and here we don't have any letter from these. So it means this is a empty set. Then next, X says that X is equal to 5n, n is a whole number and X is less than 60. This X is less than 60 they have given, we have to take the whole number. So whole number means n value will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and we 5 multiple we have to take. So 5 multiples from 0 you have to start 500, 515, 5210. Then 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, then continue down, 50, 55, only less than 60 we have to take. So here also we have countable number of elements, so this is a finite set. And cardinal number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Total 12 elements are there. Next question number 2, which of the following describe the same set? So here this set is given in description form and here it is given in tabular form. So first we will change in the same way, tabular form we will change, and then we will check whether both are same or not. So vowels of English alphabet, vowels of English alphabets are A, E, I, O, U, and this second set also is given A, E, I, O, U. So it means these both the sets are same set. Both are equal. Second, it is given A, B, D and next is given D, A, B, B. So A we will compare here. A is there in this, yes. B is also there and D is also there. Repetition we will not see and order also doesn't matter here. So this set we can write as A, B, D and this another set also is actually A, B, D only. D, A, B. Order doesn't matter. So these two sets also are same set. Third, we have letters of puppet and P, E, T, P, U. So this letters of puppet first we will write in roster form. So P is there, E, U is there, then E is there and T is there. And this second set we have E, T, P and U. Now we will compare P, yes it is there in both the set, U also is there, E is also there and T is also there. So these two sets also are same set. Fourth one, first set is having 1, 2, 3 and second set is having 2, 3, 4. So you can see here this 1 is not there in second set and here this 4 is not there in first set. So these two sets are not same. Fifth, first set is given in tabular form and second set is given in set builder form. So first we will change into tabular form this second set. First we will write as it is and second one we have X says that X is a natural number. Natural number start from 1 and we have to go less than equal to 5. Equal to means we will take 5 also. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now you can see after changing into the same form that both the sets are same sets. So both are same sets. Next question number 3, which of the following pair or groups are equal sets? So here few sets are given. So first we will convert all the set in the same form. We will convert into the tabular form. This is given in set builder form. This is in description form. So we will change into tabular form and then we will compare which are equal. So first already it is given in tabular form, we will leave it. Second set is given B. X says that X square less than 10 and X is a whole number. So we will start from whole number. Whole number start from 0. So from 0 square we will start. 0 square is 0, then 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, and 3 square is 9. And after 4, 4 square we will get 16, which is more than 10. So only starting 4 whole numbers we will take 0, 1, 2, and 3. Next, C is given letter of word follow. So F, O, L, W. O and L is repeating two times, but we will write in set notation only one time. D is given days of week. Days of week are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday till Sunday. E is X such that X is a whole number and X is less than 4. So whole number less than 4 are 0, 1, 2 and 3. F is given letter of words flow. So F, L, O, W. Each letter is coming one time. G already it is given in tabular form Monday, Tuesday till Sunday. And H is given letters of word wolf. Letters of word wolf are W, O, L, F. Now we will compare from starting which all sets are equal. So you can see here first A is having 0, 1, 2, 3. B is also having 0, 1, 2, 3. And E is also having 0, 1, 2, 3. So A, B and E are equal sets here. Next, then C, F, O, L, W. And F also F, L, O, W. Order is different but elements are same. And H is also having F, L, O, W. So these three sets C and F and H. These three sets are equal. So we can write C, F and H are equal. Then after this, you can see D is days of a week, Monday, Tuesday till Sunday. And here G is also same, Monday, Tuesday till Sunday. So D and G are same. So D and G are equal sets. So first change into the same form and then it will be easy for you for comparison. So in this video we will do till here. Remaining questions we will continue in next video. Thank you for watching this.